Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another Murph Plays Super Metroid for Super Nintendo, as presented by Nintendo Switch Online. Alright, let's get right into this, shall we? Bear with me a moment. There we go. Now we've got some audio. That happens sometimes. The Switch card will show video, but not audio, until I've disconnected and reconnected it. My GameCube card, though, kinda. Does its own weird thing where it'll disconnect. And then we only have audio. Okay. I have no idea where we're supposed to go. I know we killed Kraid. We have the Varia suit, morphing ball, bomb, high jump boots, charge beam and spacer. There's a lot left of this game. I don't know how long I'm going to play today. Like, I don't wanna wimp out, because I mean it's Super Metroid. We've been enjoying the playthrough on this. It's not so bad. But I am feeling a tad under the weather, not gonna lie. And also, my arm's been bothering me today. What is going on here? Y'all are hearing that, right? I'm having some very strange audio issues here. Like, very strange audio issues. Okay. I figured out what was causing it. The Switch capture card, which, as I had mentioned before, I was using that to the capture the audio. Previously. But the audio kept desyncing. Oh, this again. Seriously, what is going on here? Okay. Sorry. This game is being unstream friendly today. Also, my throat is not having a good day. Thank you. Sorry about that. Oh, I had to go grab my inhaler. How did I know that was there? Because I've been watching videos. Like, I still have no idea where I'm going, but... Oh no, it's lava again. Get to this dang door. One way or another. Okay. Okay, I get the feeling speed boost is going to be a thing we're going to get pretty soon. I don't know if it'll happen this stream. Because I'm still not even sure how long I plan on being on. It's not been a real great morning. But that's mostly my own doing. And mostly just things not quite cooperating as well as I had hoped. Like I said, feeling a little under the weather today. The kid was up late. Later than I had hoped he would be. And, while he does normally sleep through the night, last night he decided, nah. To be empty. I could swear there was more to that room. I just can't remember what more there was to that room. Yellow doors need power bombs. We don't have power bombs. This looks like something I can blast my way through. And not get very far. What about this side? No? No? Okay. But yeah. So the thing that's been going on with me lately is I have been trying to make the little basement apartment that I've moved into a bit more habitable. I mean, it's not bad. It's not like it's a, you know, it's a terrible basement or anything. It's totally finished. Even partially furnished. When I got here. But, I've got a lot of stuff. I mean, I had my own full apartment when I lived in Duluth. And, well, basically, we had filled that. Me and my son. So it would stand to reason that, moving down here into this basement apartment. My mom's provided us. It's a little cramped. Especially since I threw out all the shelving that I had when I lived in Duluth, but I was never a big fan of those shelves. You know? I had a lot of the kind of shelving you might have had when you were in college, living in the dorms. You know, the wire rack squares that you put together with the little plastic clips. And I wanted to update, you know, because those were old, they were junky. They had not held up very well over time. No surprise there. But, it wasn't until recently that I purchased some new shelves. And by recently, I mean, like, this week. That's how recent. I've got a pretty awful dust allergy, though. And so, putting these things together has, kicked up a lot of wood dust, because they're brand new shelves. Like, they have wood, they have sawdust on them. Plus, reorganizing everything around here. Oh, I'm supposed to run, aren't I? I didn't do that. Trying to reorganize so that I can actually, like, put these shelves in places I want them, has also been kicking up quite a bit of dust down here. Because I've been down here for about, nine months now? And that might seem like a long time to go without figuring out a lot of things. Like, my shelving situation. But, wanted to figure out what I was going to need. And, you know, what I could do with the space that I had available to me. Wanted to make sure that, you know, if I bought a bunch of shelves, I was getting what I wanted. Getting fairly decent quality. You know, I mean, given my budget, I didn't want to buy a bunch of garbage that I was just going to have to replace in, you know, less than a year from now. Want stuff that's gonna last, gonna look good. Doesn't have to be, you know, super fancy or anything, but it'd be great if it all matched, in a way.
or matched what I already had. Oh, let's see. Well, because I'm allergic to dust, and I've been kicking around all this dust, doing all this stuff to improve the situation down here, my asthma has been getting triggered a lot lately. So... been finding that I've been having to reach for my inhaler a lot more than I usually have to. It's a little frustrating, but... Alright, where do we... Wait, do we have... Energy recharge, okay. I honestly have no idea where I'm supposed to go next. I need Ice Beam if I'm gonna go that way. I don't have Ice Beam yet, do I? No. No, I do not. But also, so... been triggering my asthma awful. Something awful. I've also been triggering my carpal tunnel putting these shelves together. Why you no jump, Samus? See, there you jump too soon. Jump! To make matters even worse, because... apparently, I am a glutton for just the worst kind of punishment. I haven't exactly been eating the healthiest while I've been working on this project because, like, taking the time to cook and whatnot, who's got that kind of time? Put together shelves, rearrange the basement, and cook? Yeah, no, I don't got that kind of time. So... I've basically just been living off of pizza for the past few days. Not terrible, but, like... after 3 days of just pizza, you kind of stop wanting pizza. So, you know, been feeling less than great because of that, all of that combined. In addition to the lack of sleep from my son keeping me up at night, it's been a fun couple of days. So, oof. This stream may end up being a short one just because. I don't have to do the jump there.
was thinking I had to do the jump. I don't need to do the jump.
Okay.
Cause yeah.
With the speed boost, there's the shine spark jumping. They expect that a lot of Samus. I'm not good at it. As you'll all see soon enough. I feel like I've already been here. And it went exactly this well the last time. Darn seahorses spitting fire. Okay, this looks like familiar territory. We missed this door. Yes, of course I would like to save. Mostly because I am pretty sure I am most likely to die as a result of my own ineptitude. No, we've already been that way. We don't need to go that way. May need to go this way again, though. Did I go down before? I did go down. I may have to go down again, though. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little lost. I honestly have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. It's okay, though. That's normal. If you aren't at least a little bit lost some of the time, you're not playing Metroid right. Through there already. Yeah, can't get much further than that. We still don't have power bombs, so we can't get through there. I'm probably going completely the wrong way, but that's all right. I'm not too worried. Well, we haven't gone through here yet. Okay. Should have waited for it to go back up. If it goes back up. I am just not quick enough. Okay. Still not quick enough. Oh no! I had it that time, too. I just decided I didn't want to stand there anymore. Oh, come on. That was terrible. It's like I didn't even try. Okay, that was dumb. Yeah, no, that was really dumb. So we figured that part out. Don't have grapple beams. Going that way is not going to be helpful. Back to full health. Okay. We've already been this way. Where do I get the grapple beam? We got speed boost, but like, that's very limited in its usefulness, particularly to me, because I'm not great at it. Going the right way. I think so. I might be. Thank you. Although... Doesn't last very long. That was terrible, Samus. Oh, I missed. I need to hit, I think, this one. Maybe? I mean, I could also be entirely mistaken. Yeah, I'm entirely mistaken. It's none of those. Ah, get up. Jump. Ice beam. Now we're talking. Oh, of course. God, I'm terrible at this part. Promise you, Samus was on the elevator. Thank you. I made it. That's not helpful. Come on. Can we not be in the flower for a minute? Can we get out of the flower? I'd like very much to not be in the flower, please. Save station. We should probably save because my life has been fairly teetering on the brink of death a lot lately. In fact, let's do some very cheap health grinding. I already feel like it's time for a nap. I enjoy this game, I want to keep playing it, but I've also been fairly under the weather. Thankfully, it is Thursday. Tomorrow is Friday. Tomorrow we have Breath of the Wild, which I'm looking forward to. I mean, don't get me wrong, this has been a pretty fun game to play as well. And Metroid 2, also pretty enjoyable. I do find it kind of intriguing that so much of the plot that becomes important later seems to have happened in Metroid 2 with the infant Metroid. Because as we've seen a number of times in, you know, both this game's recap and Other M's recap, that infant Metroid is pretty important. And spoiler alert, becomes important for Metroid Fusion as well. In fact, there's a whole tangent there. That doesn't happen without that Metroid.
And from what I understand
of the plot of Metroid Dread, which I have not played much more than what you've seen me play, I basically have not touched it almost at all since the little bit of a play session that we did on the on the channel here. I don't have that yet. Where do I get the power bomb? Because that's the thing I need. So we gotta backtrack a little bit. No secret tunnel. Sometimes there's a secret tunnel. You never know. But the little bit of Metroid Dread that I have played, because I've played a little bit of Metroid Dread. Like I said, not a whole lot more than what you all got to see on the stream, but I did play a little bit more. I enjoy it. It's a fun game. A worthy successor. And I am looking forward to getting to that here in our franchise playthrough. Up there. Come on. Yes, power bomb. missile. Okay, so we have the power bomb now. Which is good because everything we need to do now seems to require a power bomb. We better save. Okay, so apparently the speed boosting my way through there isn't going to do anything. Ammo. no longer useful to us because we already have the map. I need the gravity suit and the X-ray scope there, I think. So if I remember right, there's a hidden platform or something I need to jump on. Thank you. grappling hook. Hopefully I don't need it. I feel like I do though. Okay. I'm gonna need a grappling hook. Or better timing. Probably a grappling hook, though. Oh, welcome to the chat, Kivnastics and Stovetop. Yes, this is my first playthrough. At least this is the first playthrough where I'm going to go with actually trying to beat the game. I have played this before. Just, it's been a very long time. And I don't think I ever beat the game. I'm not sure exactly how far I got, but it wasn't very. You brought a bunch of speedrunners. Oh boy. I am, yeah, hopefully not, because, yeah, I'm not very good. Ah, come on. There we go. Come on, Samus, you can do it. Oh, sure. Just project yourself right into the spikes. It's fine. Yeah, we got raided. Apparently someone decided that they needed to bring some speedrunners in to watch me flail around at this game a bit, I guess. So yeah, that'd be Kevnastic. It is a fun game to flail around and just explore. I've been a longtime fan of the Metroid franchise. I've just basically been doing this franchise playthrough since... When did we start this? January? February? So, we've already played the original, beat that one. Mother Brain gave us some problems. Mondays, I've been playing Metroid 2. We're making some pretty good progress on that one. And we've been doing this one on Thursdays. The goal is, once we beat this one, we're going to do Metroid Fusion and Metroid Prime simultaneously. Those two I have beaten in the past. And, it was actually Metroid Prime that really sucked me into this. I had played Metroid way back when, because, you know, I had a Nintendo as a kid. But, the game didn't really spark my interest until Prime came along. And then, it was a friend of mine who was a diehard Metroid fan, like, just loved the series, convinced me to pick it up, give it a try. And, like, normally I'm not a fan of, first-person shooters at all, but I gave it a shot, you know. Found that to be alright. Let's see. Have we been down that way? We've been down that way, I think. Oh, we still don't have the grapple hook. But, I have beaten Zero Mission, not on stream, just, you know, that and Fusion were, the games that I had with me when I was, driving 18-wheeler, so. Yeah, we need the grapple to get across there. And if we go this way, we run into a dead end without that grappling hook as well. Oh no, this takes us back to the ship. Which is alright. Going back to the ship is never a bad time. But, yeah, when I drove 18-wheeler, had a Game Boy Advance SP, had, Metroid Fusion and Metroid Zero, Zero Mission in the truck with me. So I'd play that when I was sitting around waiting for, you know, somebody to unload a trailer or something. Yeah, it's been a while since I did that professionally. I don't drive 18-wheeler anymore, but that is where my my first real, you know, dive into the Metroid franchise took place, was during my my 18-wheeler driving days.
Let's see. That looks like a
floor I can pass through. You know, it wasn't bad driving it. I actually enjoyed it. The thing that changed in my life, though, that made it so that driving an 18-wheeler was no longer... that's why we can't get through there. We've still got to get the other three bosses. That's the boss room. The reason I can't drive 18-wheeler anymore is because I'm a single parent of an autistic child. He would not do well on the road. He would be quite miserable. So... I'm pretty grounded. But I have plenty of other hobbies and interests. Oh yeah, like, I've got this kid a Game Boy and a Nintendo Switch Lite and everything. And... like, he stays pretty well entertained for about 20 minutes. if you're an OTR on the road for 8 hours or more at a shot, that's a long grind for a child to just sit and do nothing. Yeah, 8 hours can be a short drive, too. Oh, why does my... my frame rate keeps giving me issues. When I get hit, Samus turns invisible sometimes. Oh, that's already closed off. Guess we're not going that way. Do I even need to go that way, though? That's the question. Is there anything that way? There is something that way. Okay. So let's see if we can pull this off. Yeah, he lives with me full time. Like, his mother doesn't live terribly far away, but... we don't live together. She's got her own family. Ooh. Reserve tank. Missile. Like, he lives with me full-time, she's got her own thing that she's doing with life, whole different family and whatnot. Missile! Only reason I knew that was there is because the video that I was watching earlier. There was a... aha. The guy in the video. When he got there, he collected all of those. I would have just been like, oh, hey, the first thing, and then I'd have turned around and walked right away, right out. So, I try to be, you know, I try to be kind of entertaining. Okay, so we've got to get through there now? No. Do we go back this way? No, that's gonna be closed before we even get through there.
Alright, let's see here.
Wasting my power bombs. There must be a way through. I think. Maybe there's a way through? Ah! We figured it out, guys! We figured it out! Yeah, Ube and Knitting Link are quite regulars to the channel. They've been watching me play Breath of the Wild. They got to watch me play the first Metroid. They even stuck it out while I played Metroid Other M, and like give them a round of applause for that, because that was a disaster piece if ever I saw one. If any of you are fans of Other M, why? just why? Why are you fans of that? I was not a fan of that. I found that to be kind of you know? The baby's hardly in that one. Like, you get the little, like, you get the little bit of a clip where you get to watch the end of the fight with Mother Brain, where the baby saves Samus's butt. But, like, the rest of the game is just Samus, like, simping over Adam and, like, ignoring the fact that she has a ton of weapons. She has, you know, all kinds of cool stuff that she could be doing. But instead, no. Let's not use any of the cool stuff until we're told that it's okay. And she takes it a bit far. I mean, she had the Varia suit the whole time and decides not to use it. Until Adam tells her to use it. You know how useful that would have been earlier? Like, all the time. She should just have that going. But no. Very weird. But we did make our way through that. I don't think I have a reason to go down here, do I? No, because this is just going to be an energy fill or map data or something. You know, actually, I was going to make this a short one because I have aggravated my carpal tunnel putting together shelves for the past couple of days. I should have thought that through, but I needed places to put stuff, so I've been spending the last, like, 3-4 days assembling shelves. Not IKEA brand, but definitely very IKEA-esque in their assembly. A lot of flat pack, but, decent quality at least. The one that I put together yesterday turned out quite nice. To make matters worse, I have triggered my my asthma quite a bit lately because of the sawdust and the just general dust from moving stuff around. So there's also that. actually, didn't run into any missing parts this time, so I was quite pleased with that. I was concerned that would be an issue. I really need to stop wasting those, don't I? But, on top of that, my kid has been, waking me up in the middle of the night. Just, he'll wake up in the middle of the night, and he'll start jabbering, just talking away. So I have to tell him to go back to sleep. And last night he did that like 4 or 5 times. It was a little excessive, but, you know. I think his deal is all of the boxes and shelves and stuff. He's not entirely sure what's going on. And last time there were that many boxes around, we moved. So. Where am I going here? That way. He doesn't do very well with big changes. And trying to rearrange the furniture, clean things up a bit, get things out of boxes and whatnot. So it's been a lot of change for him. I mean, he's been tolerating it like a trooper, but can't say I blame him for being a little restless at night. But when he gets restless at night, he has a tendency to wake me up and keep me up for a good part of the night, and, yeah. So I've been running on about half the usual sleep. And, oh boy. Am I feeling it today? But, nice part is, I'm almost done getting everything set up here. And it only took me 9 months. But, when everything is all set up, I'll have a pretty decent little kitchenette area so that I don't always have to go upstairs to make dinner. There'll be, I just came from here, didn't I? I did. We want to go that way, though. But, we'll have a nice little kitchenette area. There's gonna be, we've got a little living room set up. I just came from here. But, I'm also gonna have my photo studio set up. Because I just bought myself, a new decent camera. First new decent camera since probably college. Which, I'm almost 40, so y'all can do the math. I'm old. But I'm looking forward to getting back into photography because I enjoyed it. I enjoyed photography quite a bit. This isn't something, is it? No. I had to check. Wait a second. I can go through that floor. But I got a really fantastic deal on some studio lighting, brand new studio lighting, green screen setup, and all of this is in addition to a $600, you know, camera bundle. So, I'm super excited to play with that. I think I can suspect this is going to be one of those you fall through the floor sort of deals. Guess it right. Oh, I guessed it wrong. But, hey, save. Yeah, once I get everything set up down here, I'll have space to, well, that was probably overkill. Yeah, had it coming, though. There we go. We can roll back through this way. Where does this take me? Just give me another shot at the, Seems weird there's nothing in here. Yeah, no, there's nothing in here. Okay. Okay. Nope, still didn't make it. All right. Ah! Okay, there we go. But yeah, once I get everything set up down here, I'm gonna be able to get back into working on my magic act, working on my hypnosis. All kinds of good projects and stuff while the kid's in school. Come on, Samus, you can do it. I believe in you! You're not gonna do it, are you? Come on. Like them. See how they're doing that? You do that. You were hoping I'd struggle a little bit more in that room, huh? Yeah. Yeah. Like... when I don't struggle, I am surprised by it. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not great at most video games. But... like... I got a little practice in Metroid. You know. Like I said, I played Fusion. I played Zero Missions. I played Prime. I even played a little Dread. I haven't beaten that one yet. But I'm hoping that's going to be one of those that I'm going to play on stream here after I get through all the rest of these games. That's what I'm doing. Pressing away from the wall while I jump. But, like, sometimes she's already drifting too far away. I don't think the jump is registering. Nope. Yeah, that's the problem. I don't think I'm hitting the timing right. Because you can see her do the brace against the wall, and I'm pretty sure I'm hitting the jump during that. But she doesn't... she doesn't seem to respond, and I'm thinking it's because I'm not timing it as well as I think I am. Almost. I did it! I made it! Huh. I think I'm gonna wait for Spring Ball to get through there. Because I know that's a pickup that I have to get. And that was already painful. I don't want to have to do it again because I attempted to pick something up that, Okay, so now the question is, do we try for that energy tank again? All right. Anybody know how many squares away I have to jump? Do I have speed boost? I do have speed boost. Will that help here?
Whoa!
Then I screwed it up. And I am not going to get out of there. There we go. There we go. Yeah, the problem is I don't know where the gap is. Come on, Samus, you were doing it just fine a second ago. There we go. Yeah. You gotta spin. There you go. You got it. There you go. Yeah. We're gonna get so good at this. So what's the other one for? Is that just to get you up here or to that tunnel you gotta try to morph ball through? Cause yeah, I'm not gonna be able to pull that jump off. I know that for sure. Okay, so next one? Or am I standing on the last square here? I think I'm standing on the last square here. Yeah. Okay. Oh, didn't even jump. Okay, but we know where the edge is. Ow. Oh, I really have got to fix the frame rate. Leftovers. Come on, Samus. There we go. Alright. Oof, I'm gonna have to farm some health pretty soon if I don't watch out. Yeah, no pressure. Only a bunch of speedrunners watching me on my first playthrough. But you know what? I'm alright with that. So, that's the ledge. Oh! Still don't make it. Okay. I think we are going to have to try to speed boost through that. Which I'm not a fan of because I'm not great at speed boosting. I'm absolutely terrible at shine sparking. It's been the bane of my Metroid playing. Yeah, but you have to jump at the right time. Like, I know I don't need to shine spark there, but I still need to jump at the right time. And timing it is never been real great. Should be able to jump from earlier than I think. All right. Gotta jump earlier than that. Yeah, I mean, they seem pretty cool as far as, you know, speedrunners. I mean, they don't have an elitist attitude towards somebody trying to figure this out. Which I'm okay with that. Because, yeah, I'm terrible at this. Much as I enjoy the Metroid franchise, I do know my limitations. And, yeah. I knew he was gonna do that. We're going to get really good at the wall jumping by the end of this. That much I know. Okay. We did it! We made the jump! And now I'm gonna take away the energy tank, so if I ever have to do it again, I'm not gonna know where I need to jump. Super missile! Thank you. Alright, that seems to be all that's in here. And jump! And of course we land right here. But let's save, because we got the tank! Yeah, there isn't a game that I would comfortably say that I'm good enough to attempt speedrunning. Like, I can get probably to the end of Super Mario Brothers pretty quick, but, like, nothing compared to speedrunner records, that's for sure. Legend of Zelda, first one on NES. I am pretty decent at that game. My claim to fame there, though, is I know how to do a no sword playthrough of the first quest, but that's it. Not exactly a speed run. In fact, you really can't go very fast without a sword. Yeah, no, we're just gonna go through here. Cause that just comes out here, and then we go back up here. Helps if I'm using the right one. There we go. I mean, I might be able to pull off, like, a Ocarina of Time speedrun. Maybe. But I'm not, not real familiar with all the glitches and stuff they've found that enable the super fast runs on that one. Of which I am aware that there are definitely some. Okay, here we want to do that. We came down here for a reason, bird. Yeah, the Super Mario Brothers speedruns are insane. Which is why I can't even get close to meeting their time on that. Like, for me, the speed run that I'm able to pull off on that, the best time, is using the warp tubes. And then I get stuck in World 8. And then I suffer tremendously because I really don't know what I'm doing. Like, I have beaten Super Mario Brothers, but, like, it wasn't very quick. Okay, we don't have the means to get through there yet, I don't think. Or do we? Am I just being... Okay, so it opens up the spike pit, which doesn't seem to me to be very useful. Yeah, I know there's this weird little, like, wall bounce, morph ball bomb trick that I've seen some people pull off. That's beyond my capabilities. Y'all have a great time, Ube and Knitting Link. We will talk to you next time. Don't forget, tomorrow, Breath of the Wild, we are completing the compendium. I've got, I don't even remember how many entries yet we still have to finish. But, we're almost done with that one. Hopefully we'll get the Lord of the Mountain to show up. Okay, let's see. Have I been here in a while? Oh yeah, there's that, but I need, what did I need for that? Gravity? The gravity suit? Or the grapple hook for that one? That's why I wasn't able to progress further there. Let's go back to Norfair. I'm close to where I need to be. Am I right in thinking I need to go back to Norfair? Yes and no. Wasting super missiles again. Yes, okay. Sure. Oh, I remember this part. There it goes. All right. I don't have... have the gravity suit, though, so is this going to be a problem? Maybe. Can I go down? Is that a bad idea? Eh, not the worst idea. Don't do my radio without the gravity suit. Yeah. Pretty sure I'm gonna want the gravity suit. Samus is not a good swimmer. Okay. Norfair. All right. Been up. We apparently haven't been down though. Okay. I feel like this is going to require some speed boost. Usually when there's a long straightaway like this. No? Guess not. Oh, wait, yep. Yep, there it is. Okay. Need to watch what I'm doing. That's what I need to do. Gravity hook. Or the grappling hook. Getting gravity suit and grappling hook. Confused. I am tired. All right. Play for a short while longer, and then I'm probably gonna call it. But I need to go get some lunch, and I should probably try to catch a nap before the school day ends, and I have to go pick up my son. Otherwise, I will not have a chance to nap the rest of the day. There we go. Where's this take me? Oh, hey, I remember this room. Sort of. I don't think we accomplished anything important in here. Pretty sure we also needed the, grappling hook. For something in there. Let's go this way. Hey. Energy, right? Yes. Okay. How far are we talking? Doable. I may regret that, but we saved recently, so we're okay. It's hardly sequence breaking, in my opinion, if it's not that difficult to pull off. And all I did there was tolerate some lava. Okay, that looks like Ridley's room, though, but I think we either need to figure out how to drain this lava, or figure out a way to be able to get through that lava really, really fast. I don't believe I have enough health for that. Okay, where am I? I'm on that side. Okay, that's not terrible. I know I'm intended to have the grapple before I go that way. But like, if they really wanted to keep me from being able to get through there, they're gonna have to try harder than just a floor full of lava. Now, if they had made the floor, you know, deeper,
and put a ledge at the end that I wouldn't be able to jump over from standing in the lava. That would have been a challenge. Okay, so there's nothing in this room, just me getting my butt kicked by a bunch of bugs. All right. Let's go this way. Okay, this looks familiar. Sort of. Well, see, like I said, that's not nearly enough of a challenge, man. Like, if you're really gonna stop me, you gotta make the floor deeper, and you gotta put a ledge that I can't jump over at the very end. Oh, I know I'm going the wrong way. I'm not nearly, going the right direction. But I'll figure it out here at some point. I do see a door there, though, that I haven't gone through. Ah! Map data. Okay. So there's something there. And we gotta get down through there. All right. Oh, yeah. Like, I'm familiar with the Metroidvania. Explore everything, blow everything up. Break it and just try all the things in every little nook and cranny you can find, because chances are there's a secret tunnel somewhere that you're gonna miss. I don't think I want to go back that way just yet. I mean, I know that's probably the way I need to go. But there seems to be something here. Ah, that's why I can't go any further that way. All right. So way to go is this way. Okay. All right.
Save room. I don't have wave yet. Missile. I froze the horsey. Reserve tank. I did not know that that was going to be there, but I'm not going to complain, because more missiles is more fun. Okay. Let's see. There's something there. If I can get to it. I've probably tried. Yes, down. Now that one, this one. Okay, no, I didn't have Ice Beam last time I was through here. So, we are... We are doing something different. Thank you. need you to run faster, Samus. There we go. Alright. Oh, we're back here again. Okay. Okay. I think I need the grapple hook to get to that, don't I? Because I have to go across the ceiling. If I remember right. You've seen me wall jump. Are you sure that's something that you believe I can pull off? Oh, I should have. That should have been a dash jump. You think I could do this with one wall jump? Oh wait. Can I freeze you? No, I can't. I can't freeze you. Yeah, I don't think that's the thing I can pull off yet. Not without the grapple hook. Probably going the wrong way. But yeah, I can't go through there yet. I should really try taking the platform sometime. Why not? There's a couple of squares here I've missed. Whoop. Okay. We've already been that way. Oh, what time is it anyway? Oh, 12:45. Yeah, no, I'm gonna have to sign off here. I've gotta go get myself some lunch, and then I really do need a nap before I have to, pick the kid up from school, otherwise I am going to regret it. He's gonna have all the energy in the world when he gets home from school, and I'm gonna have none. Anyway, I want to thank you all for joining me for this session of Super Metroid. We'll be playing this again next week. Hopefully, I'll be in much better shape and actually have an idea of what I'm supposed to be doing. Let's see. Tomorrow is Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, completing the Hyrule Compendium. Saturday, public domain horror movie at midnight, if I remember to find one. Monday, we're back to playing Metroid 2. We've got 13 Metroids left to hunt down, if I remember right. So, hopefully, we'll be finishing up that game on Monday, and if we do, I'll be playing this both Monday and Thursday until we complete this one, and then once we're done with this one, Metroid Fusion, Metroid Prime, once we complete those, Metroid Prime 2 Echoes and Metroid Prime 3 Corruption. That'll be fun. Tuesday, I report a... I can speak words good. Tuesday, I record a podcast with my friend Zeph. We talk about weird stuff. Last Tuesday, we missed it this past Tuesday, but I was feeling under the weather then. Worse than today, but yeah. So next episode we'll be talking about psyops and the weird tricks cops use while interrogating you. And how disinformation campaigns have led to some very unusual legal arguments. So feel free to join us for that. That's usually a later one in the evening because Zeph is a vampire, doesn't like the light. Wednesday, more front end web development. We'll be tackling how to do layouts in CSS to make your HTML look super fancy. And that brings us back to Thursday, where we'll be playing Super Metroid again. Yay! So that's what's coming up. Join us for what you can, for what you feel like, putting in front of your eyeballs. I don't mind if you're not into the web development or if you're, if you don't really care about the podcast or whatever. I mean, I do a variety of content because I understand there are a variety of interests and I have a variety of hobbies. So, I try to bring a wide variety of stuff to my channel. Join me for the things you like. Until next time, though, have a great one. And again, thanks for watching. Thank you.